In this video, you'll learn how to set up Unity for reinforcement learning so that you can run some cool projects like this. Let me show you some more. I hope you liked the short summary of example projects. After this video, you'll be able to run all of them and a few more. But first, I'd like to say welcome to the first video of my Reinforcement Learning in Unity series. Before we start, let me introduce myself. My name is Chris, I'm 24 years old and currently studying for a master's degree in computer science at the University of Applied Sciences in Mannheim, Germany. But now, let's get started. First, we need Unity, so I'd recommend installing Unity Hub. With Unity Hub, you can install different Unity versions and then select the one you need when creating a project. When you've started and downloaded Unity Hub, you should head to the Install section and add your first Unity version. I'm using version 2019.3. There might be newer versions, don't worry about them. You could select them, but I can't guarantee that it works then. It will work with this version, and don't worry about the numbers behind it. If it's 2019.3, it's fine. After that, please head to the next section. There are a bunch of options. Ignore them for now. Just click on Done. It will start installing. And after installing, it should look like this. Actually, I'm having WebGL support activated. It's for another project with this version, so you won't have it here and you don't need it, so don't worry about this as well. Next, you need a toolkit called ML Agent. It is developed by Unity Technologies, it's published on GitHub, so it's open source. And when you click on it, you can see it's quite actively maintained. 23 hours ago, 2 days ago, yesterday, that's quite nice. And another thing that's quite nice is the release 1. It's a first stable release and it was published only a few days ago. So that's a version we are going to use for the setup and we can easily download it here. When you've downloaded the repository, you should have a zip file. Just unzip it and store the folder wherever you want. I have mine in Reinforcement Learning. So you can see it here, it's called ML Agents Release 1. And in here are a bunch of folders. The important ones are project. These are the projects that you've seen earlier in my video. I'll show you in the next steps how to set it up in Unity. And after that, we need the ML Agents and ML Agent Envs folders. Those are Python libraries that we need to install via Python to train our own reinforcement learning agents later. So first we start with the project folder. For this, we open Unity Hub and we click on Add. And if you haven't already selected, just go to your location where you stored the folder. Like for me, it's this path and select the project folder. If you click on Select Folder, it will create this project or add this project to your workspace. I've already done it. It should look quite similar to this one. And after that, just click on it to start it. I've already opened it, so let me just change the desktop. So you might see a different scene or even nothing, but that's not important. Let's first go to Window and open the Package Manager. What we need in here is the ML agents package for Unity. There, if you can't see it, it's because it's a preview package, and you need to go to advanced and activate the show preview packages. Then you can see it here. If you open it like this, you can click on see all versions and select the version 1, and then you can click on install. If you've installed it, just go to the assets folder. And in the assets folder is an ML agents folder, and in there are all the examples. So I've opened the soccer example. To open it, you need to click on scenes and open the scene. And that's it. So now you can just run the examples. Those are pre-trained models. Let me show you. And your camera might look different. I think you'll see a single field, but I changed the camera angle for the videos you saw earlier, so it looks like this for me. And I'll also show you how to change the camera in the next videos. So for now, just try all of them or a few of them, whatever you like. It's really fun actually to go through them and see what they can do. So I'd encourage you to do that. And in the next step, I'll show you quickly how to train them from scratch. For this, like I said earlier, we need the Python libraries and we need Python installed. So let's head to this section. For Python, I'd recommend using Anaconda. It really helps you selecting or creating different environments for different projects. So you can find it by typing Anaconda download, then choosing the individual edition and click on download here. It will bring you to the bottom of the page, and here we'll use Python 3.7, and you should select the right installer depending on your system. I've already installed it, so let's see what it looks like. Okay, when you've installed Anaconda, you should see something similar to this one. And the first thing we need to do now is go to environments. You should only have the base root environment. I have a few more. For each project, I create my own environment. So you can see Candy Crush, Piano Tiles. If you haven't seen the videos, definitely check them out. And I've also created an environment Unity RL, and that's what you also should do. You can click on create here and give it a name like Unity RL, and then select Python 3.7 and click on create. Then you should open, or better, go to the Windows search and type in Anaconda. So you should see Anaconda prompt. Click on it, and the first command we need to use is condor activate and then the name of the environment we just created. For me, it is Unity RL. And now I can see in the parentheses here that the environment is currently active, so we are inside the environment. And now we need to install ML agents and ML agent envs, the Python libraries. For this, I'd recommend navigating to the folder, and let me show you here it's ML agents release 1. And just click on a random folder to get the path, and then, come on, there we go, copy it. And with cd you can change the directory, so cd and the path, and now we are there. With dir you can see what files are in the folder, it should be the same like this, and you'll see ML agents and ML agents envs, and now we can install them with a command pip install -e ml -agents, and you'll see it is installing. And we can do it for ml agent envs as well. It should take a bit longer for you, because for me it was just reinstalling. I've already installed it. So you can check if they are installed with the command conda list. And you can see there they are. And they have installed a bunch of other necessary libraries. But these, if you don't see those two lines, there is something wrong. And you should probably try again. So that's it. Clear is Linux command, so CLS for Windows. To clear everything, you don't need to do it, it's just visually. So yeah, now it's installed. You can verify if it's working by typing mlagents-learn. And you can see I get the help displayed, which commands I can use. So it's installed successfully. Now we have set up everything to train our first agent. I wanted to show you how to train it for soccer, but it takes quite a long time. So we'll use an easier example, like 3D ball. Let me zoom out a bit. All right. And let me show you the trained version again. Takes a few seconds to start. So it should look like this when it's trained. So to train it, we need to go to the command line and we need to type in the following command. I still have first run soccer in here, so I need to change it to 3D. Well, I don't need to change it, it's just a name, but should clarify it a bit more. Okay, let's go through it step by step. ML agents learn is the command to run, and the things behind it are the options. So first, and that's important, we need to link it to a trainer file. And if I show you here in this ML agents release one folder, we have a config folder. In the config folder is a training config. And the training config is the file I've opened to the right. And you can see many different configurations for different projects. So let's search for 3D ball. It's over there. And it will automatically detect that we are using the 3D ball config when we are starting the 3D ball environment. So we just need to pass the config file, not that we want to use 3D ball. Then we select, or we give a run ID. You'll see it later. It will create a folder with this name. And --train is, yeah, we want to train an agent. So if we start this, we will see that, well, nothing happens. Now something happens. You'll see the Unity logo and text here, and then it will say, listening on port 5004, start training by pressing the play button in the Unity editor. And that's what we're going to do. We're clicking the play button here, and now it will automatically detect the config that we started 3D ball. It will load the config in here and it will start training. The DL errors are not important, it's just because my graphic cards are not set up correctly. And we will see the time elapsed, the mean reward and the deviation of the reward, and this should increase. So we can see here the mean reward, for example. It increased already a bit. We can also see in Unity that it's training in like double, not even more than double speed. And yeah, it will take some time, but the reward should already be increasing. Otherwise, something is wrong. And yeah, now it's training. It will also take some time till it gets to the point what we saw in the already trained version. So I just cancel it with Control C. And the current version with the reward 4.2, or the mean reward 4.2, will be found here in a new created folders called models. And in there is the name we gave it, first run 3D ball. And there's an NN file. And that's a neural network file, and that's a file we can use to to change the behavior of the agent. So let's see, if we go to prefabs, we have the 3D ball here. And yeah, we have 12 of them. So this is like the template of the ball. It opens to the left, and here we can click on agent, and an agent has a behavior, and in the behavior parameters is a parameter called model, and that's the model, the pre-trained model we saw earlier. We can now use this model, and let me show you, and drag it in here. So we have 3D ball 1, that's a new model, and if I drag it in here, it will override with a new model. And if we are loading the scene again and start it, it will load the model with a mean reward of 4, so it is way worse than what we saw before. Let's take a look. Yeah, sometimes the ball is dropping. They already managed it quite good, but you can see it's not performing as good as before. That's because we use the newly trained model. And that's a way to train agents. I hope you like it. And you can try it for any project. It should work. Some projects will take a bit more time. I think soccer will take a full day or so. I've just run it for an hour and it wasn't so good. So just play around with it. You should now know how to train it and enjoy. This brings me to the end of the video. If you liked it, please leave a like to help my channel grow. And this was just the first part of the series. If you want to see more, please subscribe to this channel. And if you want to get notified when I upload, turn on the notification bell. Thanks, and I hope to see you in the next video.